Good evening, class. My name is Eunice Reiser, and I'll be your moderator for this evening. Welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a nonprofit, non-denominational, religious, and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of his eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio in 1931. We were incorporated in the state of California in 1958. Since then, we've established various branch schools throughout the United States and in various parts of the world. The Ontario branch was established in May of 1988. Now, in this school, we use the true, correct, and original name and title of the Father, the Word, our Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title of the Word, our Son, is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted by God. The name of the Holy Spirit, manifested in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted by Jesus Christ. Lord or God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are lords many and gods many, but we now know that each lord must have a name and each god must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. That means Elohim is the title that our Creator chose for himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any characters or letters in their alphabet that will produce the sound that is made by the letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings of the true and original name of our Father and his Son. Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, he is incomprehensible and inscrutable. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh in his pure spirit state, symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. We have drawn this cloud all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart is within the cloud. In like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and took on form right within himself as Elohim. This is the Word or Son, a super incorporeal being, that is, having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. This form could only be seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this self-same spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now there's only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. The simple yet intelligent question that we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time that he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, he called Moses atop Mount Sinai and showed him the tabernacle pattern in a vision. Yahweh instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The pattern consists of a most holy place, and court round about. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. In this school, we show proof that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. Our 10 primary constitution and aims and objectives are as follows. 1, to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as he really is and actually exists. 2, to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah, without distinction of race or nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. 3, to investigate the unexplained spirit law, a so-called law of nature, and the powers latent in man. 4, to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures compared to religions, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. 5, to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. 6, to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. 7, to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. 8, to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith which was once delivered to the sons or children of Yahweh. 9, to make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved, saving the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And 10, to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth. This evening, we will have a prayer by Dr. Maria Clemens. We have a song in between, and scripture lesson will be Isaiah, the 62nd chapter.
Let us bow our hearts in a moment of prayer. Thank you, Father Yahweh. We thank you for everything that you have done for us, all the blessings and even the chastisements. We thank you because we know that we will learn from them, and that you chastise us if you do, because it is a form of learning, and you love us. Therefore, we love you. Thank you for everything, and have mercy on us and help us to come to an understanding that we need these days. This and all things we ask in the name of Yahshua the Messiah, your only begotten Son. Let us all say, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And my Elohim
is the only ill for me.
Hallelujah. A scripture lesson for
good evening. A scripture lesson for this evening is Isaiah, the 62nd chapter, page 867, and I'll be reading the Holy Name Bible containing the Holy Name version of the Old and New Testament, critically compared with ancient authorities and various manuscripts, revised by the late A.B. Trainum, Scripture Research Association, Incorporated. Isaiah, the 62nd chapter, page 867. Got it. For Zion's sake will I not hold my peace, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest until the righteousness thereof go forth as brightness, and the salvation thereof as a lamp that burneth. And the Gentiles shall see thy righteousness, and all kings thy glory. And thou shalt be called by a new name, which the mouth of Yahweh shall name. Thou shalt also be a crown of glory in the hand of Yahweh, and a royal diadem in the hand of thy Elohim. Thou shalt no more be termed forsaken, neither shall thy land any more be termed desolate. But thou shalt be called my delight, and thy land a spouse. For Yahweh delighted in thee, and thy land shall be married. For as a young man marrieth a virgin, so shall thy sons marry thee. And as the bridegroom rejoiceth over the bride, so shall thy Elohim rejoiceth over thee. I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, who which shall never hold their peace day nor night. Ye that are Yahweh's remembrancers, keep not silence, and give him no rest till he establish, until he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth. Yahweh has sworn by his right hand and by the arm of his strength, surely I will no more give thy corn to be food for thine enemies, and the sons of the strangers shall not drink thy wine, for the which thou hast labored. But they that have gathered it shall eat it and praise Yahweh, and they that have brought it together shall drink it in the courts of my holiness. Go through the gates, prepare ye the way of the people, cast up the highway, gather out the stone, lift up a standard for the people. Behold, Yahweh has proclaimed unto the end of the world, say ye to the daughters of Zion, behold, thy Savior cometh. Behold, his reward is with them, and he work before him. And they shall call them the holy people, the redeemed of Yahweh, and thou shalt be called, sort out a city not forsaken. I have read Isaiah, the 62nd chapter. Let us all say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, tonight is Tuesday night. It's our workshop night. And our first speaker will be the Dean, Dr. Marlon Love.
Good evening, class.
Good evening.
Made it right on time.
Sure did.
Everything's fine, right?
Sure is.
It's workshop night, and there was one question. I think it was Luke, the 10th chapter, right around the 21st verse. Anybody else have anything that they've been reading and wanted to possibly discuss? I had wanted to go over some tools, some learning, teaching tools, primarily the Strong's Concordant Bible. I don't know if anybody's familiar with that book and kind of was going to talk about it. Maybe I can show it on the screen. Kind of go through how it works a little bit. I don't want to spend a whole lot of time on it. Maybe we can possibly find some things that would be beneficial with that. But the first question was Luke. Let's see. Where does it say he rejoiced? Luke the 10th chapter. The 21st verse, there was a question about, did Yahshua see something there? Can you elaborate what did he might have saw? That was a question. And I don't know. Catch it up a little bit. Where you say he rejoiced.
Yeah.
21st verse.
Start at 19.
That's fine.
Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding, in this rejoice not that the demons are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. In that hour, Yahshua rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father, sustainer of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. And turned to his disciples, he said, keep going.
Yeah, you at 21st?
Yeah.
Keep going.
And all things are delivered to me of my Father, and no man knoweth who the Son is but the Father, and who the Father is but the Son, and he to whom the Son will reveal him. Blessed are the eyes which see the things that ye see. For I tell you that many prophets and kings have desired to see those things which ye see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear and have not heard them. Keep going.
Mm-hmm.
And behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him, saying, Rabbi, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? He said unto him, What is written in the law? How readest thou? And he answering said, Thou shalt love Yahweh thy Elohim with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy strength, and with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself. And he said unto him, Thou hast answered right. This do, and thou shalt live.
So Yahshua here, he had gathered his 12, and you start at 17, and he says, and the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Yahweh, even the devils are subject unto us through his through thy name. You follow? So Yahshua had already sent a group of them out two by two to cast out devils in the people. You follow? And they were, and they began to work. And Yahshua is just letting them know that he has the power. You follow? Excuse me.
And they were announcing that he was coming.
That Yahshua Messiah was coming, right? Because they're all looking for the Messiah to come, mm-hmm. right? They're not realizing that he is the Messiah, though. Mm-hmm. He's just the one that's with the spirit of Yahweh to gather them together to do what they're doing. And he said, behold, I've given to you the power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over the power of the enemy, which is Satan and his host, essentially, right? That's captivated in our minds or in their minds at that time. Mm-hmm. And he says the hour rejoices. And that's that hour that Yahshua, he's expressing that it's coming, because he spent that hour that he's in Gethsemane before he was crucified. You follow? So he's expressing that this hour is coming, and Yahshua rejoiced in the spirit. And I'm not sure what the question was as far as what he saw, because that's the Holy Spirit seeing that he's going to have to work out a work. Is there any response back from there? It's on Zoom. If you want to speak, you can talk to the point. Anything? What I missed in the chapter? Well, huh? What is, was it, say it again?
That's what I was wondering, if it was the Holy Spirit.
Doing what? I'm not sure. Notwithstanding.
Rejoicing in the Holy Spirit.
No, you know, he's not seeing anything. He's just revealing these things to, and he's fulfilling, and he's also fulfilling these things to the Messiah come to fulfill, right? So he's going through and he's working out these 70, right? He said the 70 souls that have went out to do something. He's picking up 70 because he's fulfilling 70 elders. You got these 70 that are chosen, that Yahshua had chosen, which is a fulfilling of the 70 elders here. So he's going back through that hour, basically with the hour of dealing with Adam and Eve here in the garden, okay? Because it was he was short. An hour unto Yahweh is like 1,000. 1 hour is as a 1,000 years? A day is as 1,000 years unto Yahweh. And then there's an hour that's short. And that's why he's spending that hour, breaks down into seconds in order to fulfill that. Maybe I can find it right quick in the Holy Name. So I hope that answers your question to some degree. You got to let me know what the question is as far as what did he see or did he see something, huh? Yeah, I don't know what that was.
Oh, yes.
So Yahshua was just saying, you know, and when we say his purpose, the Messiah's purpose is to fulfill. Right. You know what fulfill means? It means to complete. I'm trying to see if I can express to her what the purpose of Yahshua the Messiah is. Ask her that the purpose of Yahshua is to fulfill, complete. Complete what? Complete the law of Moses. Ask her, does she know what the Ten Commandment law is? See? That the law was given for the Hebrews only. Nobody else. The Ten Commandment law for the Hebrews only. Now, Yahshua was a Hebrew. Yahshua came, Matthew 5:17. Yahshua came into the world to fulfill this law. We cannot fulfill the children of Israel, say the children of Israel could not fulfill this law. See? They couldn't keep it. Read here.
Matthew 5:17.
You have Matthew 5:17? Mm-hmm. Fifth chapter, 17th verse.
Matthew 5:17. Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot of the smallest part of a letter shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled.
Now, Maria, ask her if she understands what fulfill means. And tell her, how should I say, how should I say, she has a grocery list to go shopping. She writes down 10 items. She goes to the store. She goes to the store and buys everything. Now it's complete. You don't need the list anymore because you have everything, right? So tell her, Yahshua was born in this dispensation.
Sammy.
Dispensation. See? Time began with Adam and Eve. Continued on, right? Yahshua, the Holy Spirit, Yahshua is the Holy Spirit that Spirit operated from Adam all the way down to Yahshua the Messiah. When the Spirit was born, everything he does, everything he says, completes or fulfills 4,000 years of persons, places, and things. Why? That's the question. So now we use the Bible in order to see how he fulfilled these things. And we have faith in Yahshua because we can see invisible. Romans 1:19 and 20, please. See? Go.
Romans 1:19. Because that which...
Let him get it real quick. You can keep the camera there. When you're ready, let me know. Romans right after Acts.
One 1:19.
You know it. You know it. Yeah.
Because that which may be known of Yahweh is manifest in them.
See, right there. You can know something that's manifested about, you can know something about Yahweh. Because it's manifested in them. Because they were an example. Go ahead and read.
For Yahweh has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made.
You read that one more time, Eunice?
For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen.
See, Marcella. Elohim is, they saw Elohim in his clarity, in his clearness. He was created, right? And then he created the creation. Elohim is invisible to our naked eye. what we see according to understanding. And we see according to a pattern. Most holy place, and a court round about. Because he transmutes, he transformed into this threefold tabernacle. Now, the world we see, right? The trees, the water, the mountains, each other, cars, houses, physical, not invisible. Adam was born from the Mother Earth. That's the way the story goes, right? From the dust of the ground. Mother Earth. Virgin. No man but Adam. First man, Adam. Yahshua, born of a virgin, Virgin Mary. See? Virgin Mary. Virgin Earth. We can see this. We can read it because of the story, right? But the principle is Virgin Mother Earth. 4,000 year. Hold on. So you keep it there. Virgin Mary. Conceive in Nazareth. Coming down, born in Bethlehem. Coming down into Egypt. Grab me Matthew 2nd chapter 13th verse, please.
Matthew 2.
I think it's there. It should talk about him in Egypt.
You say 2:13?
Yes.
Okay, 14. When he arose, he took young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt. And was there unto death of Herod, in fulfillment of that which was spoken of Yahweh by the prophet, saying.
See right there, fulfillment. See fulfillment. Yahshua is in Egypt. Yahshua is conceived. He come down 12 years old. He comes into Egypt. And he's fulfilling everything that's happening back here. So reread what you just read, Eunice, and keep going, please.
And was there unto death of Herod in fulfillment of that which was spoken of Yahweh by the prophet, saying, out of Egypt have I called my son.
You find that verse, Aaron? So out of Egypt have I called my son. No, I need it in Isaiah. So you see that Matthew is writing about Yahshua. And that Yahshua came into Egypt until he was 12 years old, and he had to be called out of Egypt. Because the prophets was, because the prophets wrote about him. We're going to find it. You have it? I think it's Isaiah 55, out of Egypt. You find it? We're looking.
Hosea 11 and 1.
Is it Hosea?
Yeah. When I was a child, then I loved him and called my son out of Egypt.
Might be. I thought it said in Isaiah 2. Okay. Hold that spot, though. Yeah, probably Hosea. Okay. So, you have your Hosea, right?
Well, it's hard to find Hosea in Spanish. It would be H.
Or J. No. Hosea.
Hosea, okay.
That's right.
Old or New Testament?
In the old. Mm-hmm. 11 and 1. Old Testament. Did it? Give me the book. You find it? Okay. One momento. Proverbs. Between Daniel and Joel? Where is that? I got animals. Hosea, here. Hosea. Hosea. O-S-E-A. Mm-hmm. Here, just use this book. Just use this book.
Yeah, this one's easier.
You can see both English and Spanish here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are we going to start on the first chapter?
It's on 11, page 11.
Okay.
Just going to show the point of the fulfillment, and then we'll move on.
Okay.
11.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So we have Matthew, the second chapter, the 13th through 14th verse. How he was calling out Yahshua, out of Egypt have I called my son. I'm just trying to show and demonstrate what we read in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John is a biography. Tell her. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are a biography. See? Now, that was said in Matthew, and now we're going to read it in Hosea because it says, because the prophet said, the prophet Hosea said, out of my Egypt have I called my son. Mm-hmm. Read Hosea 1:11-1.
Right. When Israel was a child, then I loved him and called my son out of Egypt.
See, Israel, Hebrews, are down in Egypt. And he said, him, called his son, are going to come out of Egypt. So Yahshua, when he was a child, he's going to be called out of Egypt. Because he did this, he fulfilled what happened with the body of the children of Israel. That's fulfillment. Because he completed. He set it up here. He started here. Set the body of people up to come down out of Canaan's land. 70 souls. There's your 70 again. Those 70 souls came down. They multiplied. And that body of people was a son. And they were called out of Egypt. And Yahshua, being with them, called them out of Egypt. You follow? And they tarried here for 40 years. And then at the point in time, they crossed over the River Jordan and they returned. Round trip. Yahshua, in 33 and a half years, did everything from Adam, Noah, Abraham, and the children of Israel. You follow? That's fulfillment. And so we find places to prove that Yahshua was the Messiah or the Holy Spirit. But you can't see a person, you see the Spirit that's put the people down here for that reason, that later that we now can look back at this migratory pattern and talk about and learn about Yahshua the Messiah. Grammy, Exodus 14th chapter, the 13th verse.
Exodus 14:13.
Mm-hmm. Now, I've been working with the names, studying a little bit on the names. And I read this one section here. I'll get you the pamphlet name of this pamphlet in a minute. It's proving the name of Yahweh, I think it is. But it says, Moses told the Israelites to stand still and see the salvation of Yahweh. This is what we're about to read here in Exodus. Or see Yahshua, Exodus 14 and 13. King David, proclaims that all the ends of the earth have seen salvation of Yahweh, or have seen Yahshua. I'm going to need Psalms 98:3 in a minute. Yahweh, through Isaiah, declares, behold, thy salvation cometh, or Yahshua cometh. It's Isaiah 62:11. This is why we had this read today, okay? So I'm going to try to tie this up so we see fulfillment. Therefore, Simon, Simon Peter, must declare seeing Yahshua. My eyes have seen thy salvation, or I have seen Yahshua. Luke 2:30. It is also important to realize that the disciples and true apostles were used in the name of Yahshua and were punished for doing so. So go back and just start, and we'll see, because we need and we've been taught. Law, prophet, and fulfillment, right? Law. Prophet. Fulfillment. We showed you coming out of Egypt, right, is a fulfillment. So you have the five books, right? You got five books. That makes up the law. Out of the five books, you get 34 books. You follow? So when we talk about Yahshua in the fulfillment, we're looking at it from the law, prophet, and fulfillment. You see, that way we know what we're expressing. We went back to the prophets, right? The prophet Hosea wrote about Israel coming out from the law. So you have the law touched, the prophets touched, and Yahshua fulfilling it. Follow? And we're going to do it here with Exodus. Go ahead and read.
Exodus 14:13.
Exodus is part of the first five books. Read.
And Moses said unto the people, Fear ye not, stand still, and see the salvation of Yahweh, which he will show to you today. For the Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more forever.
Now that's Moses in the law. Exodus, right? 14. What was it? 14, 13.
Right,
14:13. Get Psalms.
Psalms 98.
14:13. Now you're doing Psalms.
98:3.
This is David, because David wrote Psalms. Okay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
And he hath remembered his mercy and his truth towards the house of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
All the ends of the earth has seen the salvation of our Elohim.
So about salvation, they're going to say, now Moses told the children of Israel to stand still and see the salvation, right? Salvation. David said that all the ends of the world, or the earth, has seen Yahweh. Reread that again, please. 98:3.
He hath remembered his mercy and his truth towards the house of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our Elohim.
Salvation of Yahweh. Elohim, you follow? You read it here, we read it here, right? About the salvation, the whole world. Now read, you got the next one?
Isaiah 62 and...
That's fine. 62 and 11.
And 11. Behold, Yahweh hath proclaimed unto the end of the world, say ye to the daughter of Zion, behold, thy Savior cometh. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him.
Isaiah, talking about salvation coming. You follow? Isaiah, talking about salvation. See, the Holy Spirit told Moses to stand still and watch the salvation. Tell her. Holy Spirit. Told him to. Holy Spirit told David to write. Holy Spirit told Isaiah to write. They're not their own. It's not their own opinion. They didn't write their own, what they wanted to write. You got the next one?
I didn't get the...
Luke 2 and 30. Luke chapter 2.
And 30.
And 30. Luke, this is fulfillment. Luke. 2 and 30.
Luke 2 and 30.
Mm-hmm.
For my eyes have seen thy salvation.
Thine eyes have seen salvation. This is the fulfillment. Luke. Keep reading a little bit.
Which thou hast prepared before the face of all people. A light to be lit the nation. And the glory of thy people Israel lighten the nation. And the glory of thy people Israel.
Mm-hmm.
And Joseph and his mother marvel at those things which was spoken of him. And Simon blessed them and said unto Miriam his mother, behold, this child is set for the fall and rising again of many in Israel.
Go up above 30 and... where it might catch up the continuity.
26.
Yeah, he's just being born, right? So, Luke. Luke's the second chapter, right? There was a decree of Augustus. That's why he had to go down into Egypt. And we started, you said about what?
Hmm?
Started with 25? 25.
Yeah. And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simon. And the same man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Spirit was upon him.
Now, the Holy Spirit was upon Simon.
Simeon.
I thought it was Peter. But Simeon, because Joshua hadn't picked him yet, right? So Simeon, we're talking about Simeon, I apologize, not right. Simon. All right. So Simeon, looking for the consultation of Israel. Marcella, remember I said that the Ten Commandment law only for the Israel or Hebrews? We're still dealing with Hebrews only, with Yahshua. Not dealing with everybody. only the children of Israel. The law, the prophets, they're all Hebrews. They're not Gentiles. They're not Asian. They're not Hispanic. They're not Samoan. They're just Hebrews. Matthew, Mark, Luke, they're Hebrews. You follow? That's the one story. That's the one nation of people that we're dealing with at this time. They were an example. Now we got Simeon, who's a Hebrew, because he's looking at what we're supposed, what they're going to receive. They're looking for a Messiah, right? A Savior. Keep reading.
26. And it was revealed unto him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen Yahweh's anointed one.
You see? See the Holy Spirit revealing to the man? It's invisible. Not everybody sees. But Simeon sees. Simeon knows the law. He knows the prophets, but he doesn't know yet who Yahshua is. He doesn't know who the Savior is. He knows this, but he doesn't see yet who Yahweh's anointed is. Keep reading.
27. And he came by the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child, Yahshua, to do for him after the custom of the law, then took he up in his arms and blessed Yahweh and said, Yahweh, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace according to thy word.
That's Simeon. Now Simeon see Yahshua, right? Right?
Yeah.
Children of Israel saw the salvation. David saw the salvation. Isaiah said there's going to be a salvation coming. Now, Simeon is taking up the baby Yahshua. You follow? So he's up here. He hasn't went down to Egypt yet because he's still a child. Because 8 days, you have to. That's why they went up into that temple, because he had to get circumcised. You follow? And so Simeon now sees the presence of Yahweh through baby Yahshua, or the Holy Spirit in the child. Keep reading. What verse you at?
Well, 29.
That's okay. Keep going.
Yahweh, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace according to thy word.
You're at 30 now.
For my eyes have seen thy salvation.
Thy eyes have seen thy salvation. That's fulfilled. Said he was waiting to see the consummation of Israel. That's Yahshua. That was the baby. Right? Keep reading.
Thou hast prepared before the face of all people.
Of all people. Now we're going to be coming. Now we're getting ready to be revealed as to who Yahshua is. Keep reading.
A light to lighten the nation. And the glory of thy people Israel. And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him. But Simeon blessed them and said unto Miriam his mother, Behold, this child is set for the fall and rising again of many in Israel, and for a sign which shall be spoken against. Yea, a sword shall pierce through thy own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. And there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of...
That's good. That's good. I go into another story. Yeah. But you see the salvation fulfilling. Now there's a spiritual salvation for us, because we know that he come to die, be buried, and resurrect. 50 days later, he's going to pour out his spirit. First to the Jews. Then, as it's called Pentecost, to the Jews first. Not everybody got anything. Only the Jews, because that's who he dealt with. Then 57 years later, the Gentiles received. Was that 11? Acts 11. I think it is. See that? So what they received was the Holy Spirit, was a knowledge, not no whimsical ghost, but a knowledge about Yahshua. He's writing it in his heart and mind. He's writing it in our hearts and minds about who he is. And they pass it down to Peter. You find it?
11:15.
Okay, just start right at the catch-all.
Okay. 12. And the Spirit bade me, 14.
Okay,
who shall tell these words whereby thou and all thy house
just
shall
listen,
be saved?
Just listen, because I'm just expressing. The Holy Spirit on Pentecost to Jews only. Now we're reading 7 years later. This is what happens. Read.
And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell on them as on us at the beginning.
At the beginning. This is the beginning. When the Holy Spirit fell on us, the Jews. Then 7 years later, the Holy Spirit fell on the Gentiles. Read.
Then remembered I the word of Yahshua, how that he said, John indeed baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Be baptized in water. Baptized in water. Why? Because the children of Israel were baptized in water back here. Okay. Now we're talking. Now he just got done. Reread what you said about baptism again.
Then remembered I the word of Yahshua, how that
Peter
said,
remembering. Read.
How that he said, John indeed baptized with water.
John baptized with water. Read.
But ye shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit.
But we're going to be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Read.
For as much then as Yahweh gave them the like gift, as he did unto us who believed on Yahshua the Messiah.
The like gift of baptism of the Holy Spirit. Read.
What was I that I could withstand Yahweh? When they heard these things, they held their peace and glorified Yahweh, saying, then hath Yahweh also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life.
Now, Gentiles going to be able to know through the events of the apostles, the disciples, Yahshua the Messiah, going to tell us about Adam and Eve, Noah, Moses, Abraham, Jonah, all the way down to Yahshua the Messiah. And now we, the Holy Spirit, gives us a revelation, which is invisible, but is understood. Dr. Kinley had a vision of both Moses and John tell the same story, but broken down even clearer. And when we see how he instituted and fulfilled, then we gain faith. Anything else there? I know that's it for the Gentiles, right?
Well, yeah.
I just wanted that little piece. Anybody have any questions about what we just ran through about fulfillment? You follow? So the pamphlet that I'm always going to have done today, but we don't have the time right now, is explaining the true name of our Heavenly Father and His Son, Yahshua the Messiah. That's the pamphlet. You can zoom in on this if you want to. We'll make this available at some point. Email us, send you the pamphlet in an electronic file. And it breaks down the Adonai. You follow? And it breaks down, again, the necessity for us to understand Yahweh, the title of Elohim, and the name of Yahshua the Messiah. Understanding that it's one name operating as the Father, the Word or Son, and the Holy Spirit. You follow? All at the same time, which gives us the name of, or the title of, Ayah Asher Ayah. You follow? So, understanding that Adonai, how it works, came to be, right? Adon, it was a god at that time. And it's expressed that Yahweh in the commandments said there would be no other idol and worship no other idol. And they right away used Adon, we call them Adonai. You follow? Because Adonai was a title that they used in order to deny or not use the name of Yahweh. You follow? So that's one thing I've been studying today or this past couple of days. But it showed forth the fulfillment. Now, we have a plethora of, we don't have the big pamphlet, huh, anymore. So we're good with that. We got the question, and I wanted to work with, help Maricela with the law, prophet, and fulfillment. You follow? Because it's very important. And then you have the spiritual fulfillment. I think that's in, where is that at? The spiritual fulfillment is the temple. I don't think that was something else. No, that's the kids one. Know ye not that your body. salvation. First Peter 1:5.
First Peter 1:5. You got it? Okay. First Peter 1:5. Who are kept by the power of Yahweh through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time.
Peter talking about salvation in the last time. So you have fulfillment, right? So I'm going to just do it this way. I have fulfillment here. But you have spiritual fulfillment. Ah, man. Let's see. This is what matters for you and me. That's all happened before, right? We're using all of this to see Yahshua. But then we want the spiritual fulfillment. Fulfillment. In us, right? Greek.
Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold trials.
Many trials, a lot of problems. A lot of sad times in the last days. We need a Savior. Right?
Right.
This age is in the realm of eternity. No time. No time in this first age. Second age. The realm of time. This time started with Adam and Noah. This third age in the realm of time with Abraham and Moses and Yahshua the Messiah. After the end of the death of Yahshua the Messiah, you have a present kingdom age also in the realm of time. 2023, right? The year. Time. Zero from the birth of Yahshua until 2023, almost 2,000 years passed from this period of time to now. In the realm of time. And we're learning about the spiritual fulfillment through the fulfillment of Yahshua and the prophets and the law. So we can have an understanding of a present kingdom age, spiritual kingdom on earth, understanding. Keep reading, please.
7, that the trial of your faith being much more precious than of gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahshua, the Messiah.
Now he's going to appear. How's he going to appear? Out of the sky? Where Jesus is going to come returning again, right? We hear that. Is he going to return again? Or is he already here? In us. Through a knowledge of the law, the prophets, and the fulfillment. The Holy Spirit enters into us. Keep reading there.
8. Whom having not seen, ye love.
Haven't seen. Can't see with your eyes. Can't see Elohim. Invisible. Takes the physical to understand the spiritual. Can't see spirit. Right? Can't see spirit. Can only understand, talking about understanding through these attributes. You can't see love. We see a manifestation of love. Caring and giving. You see a manifestation. You don't see love. Give you a rose. Oh, that's beautiful. That's a manifestation. That's not love. Reread your last one, please.
Whom having not seen, ye love.
Mm-hmm.
And whom though now ye see him not.
Mm-hmm.
Yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory.
Receiving. That's Peter talking about Yahshua, the physical body. It's gone away. Can't see him no more. In the flesh. That's what Peter's talking about. But what? Read.
Receiving the reward of your faith, even mm-hmm. the salvation of your souls.
Now the salvation of your soul is the faith. He's the faith because he's taught, we've said here and learned about Yahshua the Messiah. We see how he is the Holy Spirit fulfilling and that he's going to fulfill our needs, our troubles, our tribulations as well. Keep reading.
Mm-hmm. Of which salvation the prophets have inquired.
The prophets, they didn't know. They just wrote by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. They still had to know. But hey, remember on the day of when he was buried, he went back and preached to the captives in hell. He went back and preached to the prophets that didn't know. They didn't know. They wrote. And then Yahshua came in and fulfilled. He died. And he went back and preached to the captives in hell. And now they know. Keep reading.
Mm-hmm. Have inquired and searched diligently who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you.
They prophesied of the grace of Yahshua the Messiah that's going to come. Read.
Mm-hmm. Searching what or what manner of time the spirit of the Messiah, which was in them, did signify.
We talked about Simeon. We just talked about Simeon. And we got a name correct from Simon to Simeon. Mm. Thank you for that. But we see that Simeon that had the Holy Spirit, and his eyes saw Yahshua the Messiah, or the Holy Spirit. Mm. You follow? Now, Peter's recanting this. Keep reading.
When it testified before the hand the suffering of the Messiah and the glory that should follow.
Hey, he died on the cross. Beat him down. Bloody on this cross. No one wants to go be like this. He did that. Huh? For the whole world to know and to do. But there's going to be a reward for this suffering. What is it? Read.
Unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto us, they did minister the things which are now reported unto you.
Report. There was a report. Reread that again.
Unto whom it was revealed.
It was revealed. You didn't study up on it. You didn't figure it out. You didn't say, oh, I got it. Now. It was revealed. Where did I go? It was revealed by the Holy Spirit. It's like Dr. Kinley. He didn't figure it out. He didn't draw these off the top of his head. It was revealed or had a vision of all that we talk about. This is why we say it was the vessel that the Holy Spirit stepped into in order to draw out all that you see around here, in order for us to get an understanding or be revealed to us what the vision is about. Now, Peter's talking about here this revealing mm-hmm. about Yahshua the Messiah, because that's the only thing that needs to be revealed, because he's revealed in you, you'll see him. Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Unto whom it was revealed, mm-hmm. that not unto themselves, mm-hmm. but unto us, they did minister
to
the
us,
things.
To us, the Jews first. It was ministered unto of what the prophets talked about, what the law pointed to, mm-hmm. law of Moses. And when it was revealed to them, because the Holy Spirit revealed it, that's what he came in on the day of Pentecost. Penny meaning 50. Penny meaning the Spirit was revealed in them what they were, what they had learned for some 3.5 years when they were disciples. Now it's revealed to them the reality of who and what Yahshua was about. Keep reading.
Which are now reported unto you.
Now they reported unto you, unto the Gentiles. And now we're reporting it unto you. The things which we saw according to the vision that Dr. Kinley had, that the prophets had, that Moses had. Read.
By them that have preached the gospel unto you, uh-huh. with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven.
See, the Holy Spirit already been sent. He was sent on the day of Pentecost. He's not coming back. He's already here in the knowledge and the information within the gospel. That's why they're reporting the information. That's why we're sharing the information. There's nobody coming to save us. The boat's already here. That faith, which was the body of Yahshua Messiah, died, buried, and resurrected, and came back 50 days later into the hearts and minds of men. I'm going to need Jeremiah 31:31. Keep reading there with Peter. You grab it on the computer there, please. Keep reading there with Peter. Okay. First Peter.
Yep. I just lost my spot. Okay. Report unto them, uh-huh. that have preached the gospel unto you, mm-hmm. with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven, mm-hmm. which things the angels desire to look into.
Angels wanted to know the name of Yahweh. They didn't know the name of Yahweh. They didn't know the name of Yahshua the Messiah. Keep reading.
Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind.
Get your mind together. Gird it up. Get strong in your mind and in your understanding about Yahshua. Not your job, not your boyfriend, not your girlfriend, not the things of this world, but the things that pertain to Yahshua the Messiah. Understand the law of prophet fulfillment and spiritual fulfillment of things. Right. Understand death, burial, and resurrection according to this gospel, according to this pattern that we have, according to the tabernacle pattern. Remember, it's blood, it's water, it's spirit, it's 40, it's ascension. You follow? And you run that same plate down here. But you see, you get to some point, you got to stay in heaven. You follow? That's what that Jacob's ladder is about. Dipping and dipping and rising back up. But keep reading. That's another story. Keep reading. Okay.
Be sober and hope to the end for that gift that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Yahshua the Messiah.
The revelation of Yahshua the Messiah. You say second coming, but this is the revelation of Yahshua that's coming to us. And we be hopeful in that it comes, because why? It's going to eradicate this old earth. And you're going to live in a new earth state. Anything else there? That's what we're looking for, because he's already going to, it's just, you're going to be revealed. Now it's some good days, some bad days. We're going to come a time when it's not going to have days no more. Like the sun rising and the sun setting and the moonlight. Not going to have that no more come a day. Because it's going to be, it's going to be perfect. Set in the realm of eternity. But keep reading.
Okay. As obedient children, do not conform yourselves according to the former lusts in your ignorance.
Now that you heard the gospel, now that you realize that you didn't know, that you didn't know, that you didn't know, don't set your mind's eye back to the former things or the old things or the old ways. Keep your mind on Yahshua the Messiah, you follow, which is the Holy Spirit. It's not a man. It is a spiritual understanding about mm-hmm. your Creator and who you are. Keep reading. Mm-hmm.
But as he which has called you is holy.
He is that Holy Spirit that's called you to come into this class. Read.
So be ye holy in all your conduct.
So be ye holy in your conduct and your action. You don't need me to tell you to do this and to do that. You know what's holy and what's not holy according to the Holy Spirit. Because, see, that's the new covenant. There's that spirit law written in your heart and mind to do that will, that perfect will of Yahshua the Messiah. Keep reading.
Because it is written.
It's written. Where is it written holy. At, though? Really?
Be ye holy, for I am holy.
Uh-huh.
And if ye call on the Father, who without respect a person uh-huh. judgeth according to every man's work, pass the time of your sojourning here in fear.
Mm-hmm. You'll be passing it here in fear if you don't have the respect of that of the Father. Jeremiah 31:31, please.
Jeremiah 31:31. Mm-hmm. Behold, the days come, saith Yahweh, that I will make a new covenant.
Now look, behold, the days come, and he's going to make a new covenant. This old covenant is old. That's to the children of the children of Israel. That's old. But behold, Jeremiah is writing the prophets. He's saying, behold, the days come. Read.
That I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt.
They were brought out of there. That's an old covenant. That's everybody tuned to the Ten Commandment law, right? Love, you know, I don't even know them. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, and all those things, right? You're not going to do those. They put that on you and how to act and how to be. But that's old. Agreed?
Which my covenant they break, although I was a husband unto them, saith Yahweh. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel mm-hmm. after those days, saith Yahweh. Mm-hmm. I will put my law in their inward parts.
After these days of Yahshua the Messiah. Reread that again one more time.
After those days, said Yahweh.
Okay, after these days.
I will put my law in their inward parts.
Now I'm going to put that law in their inward parts. Read.
And write it in their hearts.
They're going to write it in their heart. We're writing into your hearts now when we preach the gospel of Yahshua Messiah. That's who he is. That's what he is. You follow? Read.
And will be their Elohim.
Now, there's going to be their Elohim. Read.
And they shall be my people.
And that's going to be his people that know his law or know who he is. That's why I say, take my yoke upon me and learn of me, for my burden is light. You follow? Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor and every man his brother.
Teach them what? Read.
Say, know ye Yahweh, for they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, said Yahweh.
How are they going to know? Unless they have a teacher, teach them. And they're going to know, only his people are going to know. The world not going to know. They're not going to know and understand. Unless you've been taught. Every knee is going to be aware that Yahshua is the Savior of the world. Mm-hmm. Every knee will bow. Right. But they're not going to know. Mm-hmm. There's going to be wailing and gnashing of teeth. You follow? But keep reading.
For I will forgive their iniquity and I will remember their sin no more.
So you're going to, once you believe in that which is teaching, that is the teacher or the faith, you're going to take away that hurt, that pain. Read.
Thus saith Yahweh, which giveth the sun for a light by day, and the ordinance of the moon, and mm-hmm. of the stars mm-hmm. for a light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar.
No, that's the light by day and the moon by night. That's only temporary. But keep reading.
Yahweh of hosts is his name.
Mm-hmm.
If those ordinances depart from before me.
If they depart, the sun rising in the morning and the moon shine, giving the shine. If they depart or if they stop, what? Read.
Said Yahweh,
uh-huh.
Then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever.
Yeah, read.
Thus said Yahweh,
uh-huh.
If heaven above can be measured and the fountains of the earth searched out beneath, I will also cast off all the seed of Israel for all that they have done, said Yahweh.
Of what you're talking about back here in the fourth dispensations now. Now, grab me Hebrews 8th chapter. And we're going to run down through that.
Hebrews 8.
Can I ask the question right quick?
Sure. Still workshop.
You were saying the angels didn't know Yahweh.
Yes.
Is that why Lucifer challenged him?
Yeah, because Lucifer did not know who the Messiah was or who Yahshua was. So he thought he was the big knees up in heaven because Yahweh said him so.
Mm-hmm.
He made him seem as though he was top dog in the doghouse. You know what I'm saying? And he wanted to be greater than Elohim.
Thank you.
And he wanted to reveal himself, wanted everybody to sing and praise Lucifer glory. You follow?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Yeah, so we can have a savior. But you have to have the mystery of iniquity run rampant. We get all emotionally tied in love and we look at all the physical things and we can't separate the spiritual from the physical. But as we begin to see that Yahshua's faith and he's the Holy Spirit and that he's guiding you, he's not going to bring you down into a state of despair and suicidal tendencies and things of that nature. You follow? Because you've understood about the one true El and Yahshua, whom Yahweh has sent. That's life eternal. Mm-hmm. And life is to know. Right? Now we're in Hebrews. We've got a little bit more time. Thank you for the question. And let's go ahead and start at one.
One. Hebrews 8 and 1. Now of the things which we have spoken, this is the psalm.
Now what we've said tonight, what we've said since we've been given this divine vision and revelation, and what we have these charts, and we have these meetings, this is still the psalm. It hasn't changed. Read.
We have such a high priest who is set on the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens.
He already ascended to the Father. He ascended up there. You follow? But he's not flesh. He's not bone.
Right.
He's not over there. He's not down there. No, he's everywhere and everything. Read.
A minister of the sanctuary and of the true tabernacle.
And he's the minister of the true tabernacle. Read.
Which Yahweh pitched and not man.
That Yahweh pitched. You didn't pitch. Your mama didn't build you up.
No.
Your daddy didn't make you. You are your own tabernacle. We are our own tabernacle. And Yahshua, the Holy Spirit, is tabernacling in us. And we're to learn about that Spirit in us and be mindful of that Holy Spirit in us. You follow? Because that's the new law that's being written based on from the gospel of Yahshua Messiah, being written in your heart and mind so you can have some stability, some strength, some love, have some beauty, have some knowledge, have some wisdom, and not about Yahshua, because it ain't to prove you. As Lucifer, we just got done talking about. That's what Lucifer wanted to do. We're not going to go the way of Cain, as it was being talked about before when Cain killed his brother Abel. We're not looking at that no more. For the second great commandment is to love thy brother as you would love Yahweh. Because your brother is Yahweh, manifested in different manifestation.
That's
just
right.
Like you have Yahweh, pure spirit, you have two manifestations. One incorporeal as Elohim, and one concrete as Yahshua the Messiah. They're one and the same, but two different manifestations. I can't be Rebecca, and Rebecca can't be me. Mm-hmm. But I can love her, and she can love me. Mm-hmm. You know? Because we are head region, chest region, and abdominal region. You follow? She has a tabernacle. I have a tabernacle, and it goes same for everybody. Mm-hmm. But to have a knowledge, each other having a knowledge of one another bonds us together in peace, right? Keep reading. Mm-hmm.
For every high priest is ordained to offer gifts and sacrifices.
I'm talking about the regular folks, the regular ministers. They got the sacrifices. Read.
Wherefore, it is of necessity that this man have somewhat also to offer.
Mm-hmm.
For if he were on earth, he should not be a priest, mm-hmm. seeing that there are priests that are offer gifts according to the law.
Mm-hmm. According to the law of Moses. These old people still giving gifts and telling the old people, saying, thou shalt not do this, thou shalt not do that. No, that's old hat, right? Keep reading. Mm-hmm.
Who serve unto the example and shadow of heavenly things.
An example? And a shadow about heavenly things. We talked about it already. This was an example and a shadow. You know what a shadow is? I'm the real thing and a shadow on the ground. And people see the shadow, but everybody's feeding after the shadow. They're not looking at the reality of what's really going on. And we're talking through the gospel, the foolishness of preaching the gospel. You see the reality of the man and not the shadow or not the example or not the do's and don'ts. Keep reading. Keep reading.
As Moses was admonished of Elohim.
As Moses was admonished, read.
When he was about to make the tabernacle.
Uh-huh.
For see, said he, that thou make all things according to the pattern showed to thee in the mount.
See, you're talking about Exodus 25th chapter, down around 40 to the 40th. But keep reading. Mm-hmm.
But now hath he obtained a more excellent ministry.
Now there's a more excellent ministry. Read.
By how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant.
Yahshua is a mediator of a new covenant. That's the better covenant. It's the new covenant, which is written in your heart and mind. And he's a mediator for us. Because we're still on earth. He hasn't revealed himself unto us. So we need a savior. We need a mediator between Yahweh and man. Read.
Which was established upon better promises.
The better promises than Abel. Read.
For if that first covenant had been faultless.
This first covenant. If this first one has been faultless, had been perfect, what?
There should no place have been sought for the second.
Well, don't need him. If this was perfect, why did he come in and die? This was made or set up to fail so that we would need him to redeem us. Keep reading.
For finding fault with it.
Fault with this one. Read.
He said, behold, the days come, saith Yahweh, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
Sound like Jeremiah to me. Read.
And with the house of Judah.
Uh-huh.
Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers.
No.
In the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
Because they continue not in my covenant, and I regarded them not, said Yahweh.
You didn't regard these people back here at that time. It wasn't meant for that. They were just meant for us to see that and to know this. Read.
But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, said Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
I will put my laws into their mind and write them in their hearts. And I will be to them their Elohim, and they shall be to me my people.
Yes.
And they shall not teach every man his neighbor and every man his brother.
See how he went back and preached to the prophets and saying the same thing? Mm-hmm. Jeremiah 31:31. Now, Saul talking about the same prophet. Read.
Saying, know ye Yahweh,
mm-hmm.
for all shall know me from the least to the greatest.
Mm-hmm.
For I will be merciful to their unrighteousness,
mm-hmm.
and their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more.
Right. Read.
In that he said, a new covenant he has made the first old. Now that which decayeth and waxeth old is ready to vanish away.
Yes. This earth plane is ready to vanish away. The earth plane. This age, physical age, about to vanish away. Anything else there?
No.
Keep reading the next chapter.
Nine.
Yeah?
Then verily the first covenant had also orders of service.
Remember, chapters don't stop. It's one letter. Now verily or truly.
Right.
Read. Truly, read. Verily.
The first covenant had also orders of service and a worldly sanctuary.
Mm-hmm.
For in the first compartment of the tabernacle was a candlestick, the table, and the showbread.
He's talking about the tabernacle, but we're going to expedite it some. Keep reading.
Which is called the holy place. Mm-hmm. And beyond the veil, the second compartment of the tabernacle, which is called the Holy of Holies, which had the golden censer and the Ark of the Covenant overlaid round about with gold, wherein was the golden pot that had manna and Aaron's rod that budded, and the table of the covenant. And over it the cherubim of glory shadowing.
That's fine. Skip down to 23. Yep. He's talking about this whole tabernacle. Saul's talking about it to the Hebrews.
23. It was therefore necessary that the pattern of things in the heavens should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves were better sacrifices than these.
See, this was the sacrifices. Every day they had to sacrifice. But then there's going to be a new one when Yahshua will write it in our hearts and in our minds. You follow? Through the gospel. There's going to be a better one. These are ones better in heaven. This is where we're at now. Read.
For the Messiah is not entered into the holy place made with hands.
He's not in here no more. He's where? Read.
Which are the figures of the true, uh-huh. But into heaven itself,
uh-huh.
Now to appear in the presence of Yahweh for us.
He's in the presence of Yahweh. Read.
Nor yet that he should offer himself often, as the high priest entered into the holy place every year with other blood.
The high priest, right? Read.
For then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world.
Mm-hmm.
But
he,
now
he
once,
suffered since the foundation of the world. This was him bringing in the world. Read.
But now once in the end of the age.
In the end of an age, this age, at the end of this age, what? Read.
He appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself.
Oh, this age. In the end of this age, excuse me. He appeared to put away sacrifices of himself. Read.
And as it is appointed unto man once to die, but mm-hmm. after this, the judgment.
Mm-hmm.
So the Messiah was once offered to bear the sins of many.
That's there. That's these many. Read.
And unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time.
Now he's going to appear to us to look for him. Seek ye Yahweh while he yet may be found. This is what we're doing. We're seeking Yahweh now. Right? Keep reading a little bit more.
He appeared the second time without sin offering mm-hmm. unto salvation.
Without any of the old covenant, but with an understanding that he's going to give that to us. That understanding. Read.
10.
Mm-hmm.
For the law having a shadow of good things to come
uh-huh.
and not the very image of the things
right.
can never with those sacrifices.
Yep.
Can you read?
For then would they not have ceased to be offered because of that worship, because that the worshipers once purged should have had no more conscience of sin. But in those sacrifices there is a remembrance again made of sins every year. For it is not possible that the blood and bulls and the goats should take away sins. This law, I'm just explaining that this law, we're going to do nothing for you. You need to have Yahshua the Messiah in you be your only hope and glory. Any quick questions out of this? I do trust and hope that you got something out of tonight's class. And again, all praises to Yahweh our Elohim by way of Yahshua the Messiah. Let us all say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do we have any announcements? Mm-mm. No? That will be the conclusion of tonight's class. And if there's no announcements, we hold classes on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7:30 to 9:30, Sundays from 11 to 1. We're at 1816 East Elmo Court, Ontario, California, 91764. So if that will conclude, we can all stand and be dismissed with the doxology taken from the last two verses of Jude. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all time, now and ever. Let us all say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Good night, Dr. Rises.
Good night, everyone. Good class.
That's good class. Good night, everybody. Take care.
Good night. Hello, Roxanne. Oh, okay. Thank you.
I didn't get the strong tone.
Huh? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, did he? Yeah, and then he gave me this. What is this? Now I'm gonna give you the big opportunity on whether or not you want it or not. It's going to, you know.
I like paper.
Yeah. You know, that's right.
you got your new toy over there?